mostly for the people who has really dry and dead skin. So what happens is that we use this pack on their skin for 3 seconds, not 3 minutes. Really smooth, subtle. That's what I'm doing. I'm just dabbing this entire cotton all over the skin. So if you have a very, very flaky and dead skin, what I would suggest you all is keep this cotton on that problematic area for some time, like just for 3 seconds, okay? And then take it. Even I think this is one of my favorite products. It is actually really, really hydrating. So what is your first step? Your first step is sleep out to water. Your second step is the 3 second face mask. Alright, now it's going to be a serum, a green tea serum that I will be using on her skin. So what does the serum do? It kind of helps us to really make our skin soft, subtle, and also it will help our makeup products to look nice and flawless. Hydrate the 3 layers of the skin. I think our makeup products blend really well on the skin. So we done with the serum. Now the next step is going to be lotion. So this is basically a lotion as well as a moisturizer. Now what does moisturizer do? For me, moisturizer is my food that I literally feed my skin. It is important to use moisturizer over your hands, feet, legs, and face, neck, everywhere. You have to feed your skin as well. Now the next important step that I want to show you all is, this is again from green tea. It's basically a eye and face ball sticky. Alright, now why do we use this is because we have already used moisturizer, lotion and serum all over the face, but we need to also treat under the skin, under the eye area as well. Why? Because that is again something very important part of our face. You see, a lot of people have these cracks under the eye, you know, flakes out, dries up. It's what exactly you need to use in order to get a flawless finish. Okay? So I am just going to push this a little bit. Next step is primer, as you all said. Making the brows look fuller. So I see she has really dark dark shade on her brows. So I am using the darker shade. If you guys have a lighter, you know, like tone to your brows, then use something which is more lighter, which is more like brown gray color. So before you start with eyes, whenever you guys do eye makeup, do you guys do eye bags?
Yeah.
Do you also conceal your eyes? Awesome. Why do we conceal our eyes? Because we do have different shade on our eye area, right? So we need to make sure at least we bring it on from the same shade of our skin tone. And then why do we use eye bags? Because we want our eye makeup to look and stay longer, to look flawless and stay for longer. So, is this only an eye base or a concealer and an eye base as well? You don't really need to invest on an eye base individually. If you have a lighter shade of concealer, at the end of the day, you need to use something which is more liquid and clean. Okay, so what I'm doing here is I'm using a concealer which is helping me to achieve and conceal the eye area, and also it is giving a nice pink color. Okay, so concealing is done. Now let's start with the eye makeup. So I'll be using something which is more fluffier and a little rounder so that it's easier for me to blend. Okay. And this is the shape that I'm using for the face as a morning makeup look. Do not be scared of this color. Okay. Eye makeup is not just about putting the eye color on the eye. It's also about shading. It's also about intensity. It's also about the way you place and position your eye makeup in an appropriate way so that your eye makeup looks really intense and also it gives a beautiful shape to your eye. So now where am I starting with her eye makeup? That is from the crease. Because that's where usually we want to see our matte eyeshadow. Also try creating a nice V shape, especially from the outer corner of your eyes. So that's how I'm creating. You see, I'm going from outside to inside in a diagonal shape and coloring the entire crease there. So I'm going back and forth and blending it really well so that nothing looks really sharp or very, you know, like, let's say patchy. Okay, you want your eye makeup to look really nice and good. Obviously, start with a very light color of eye shadow and then intensify with darker colors. But in a very short stroke. So, look down again and look that side. The next step for me as a day makeup look, I love doing liners. So, you should use this as a liner and create a line. Close your eyes. Now I'm gonna go from outside to inside. I'm creating a very thicker line on the outer corner, and as and when I'm going inside, I'm giving a very thin, invisible line. Positioning and making sure that your face is in the right position is also very important. So you might, you know, stretch your eyes a little bit, but when you go closer to the mirror, you have to make sure you look down, chin down, and then do it so that, you know, it's easily visible where exactly you're going. And the most important technique that I would like to share is sprinkle with very shorter strokes. Only then you will achieve what you want to achieve, right? So don't go straight away, you know, with one line. No. Go shorter strokes, then you'll get that neatness in your eyeliner. For really long, the entire day, I would suggest you guys really use a foundation as well. Because that's going to make your skin look flawless throughout the day. It's also going to help our entire makeup stay for much, much longer. Okay, again, notice the way I am positioned powder, it will not skip. I'm not going to dry. Why? Because I want to make up the sleep really long. And if you just add a little amount of powder, your makeup will not stay for really long. Okay, and also it can transfer on the clothes, on your phone, which you don't want, right? You want to lock your product really well. I think blush is something which is actually going to bring back that light. Like we kind of, you know, take it away by using foundation, concealer, you know, compact, because everything looks even then, right? So what helps in achieving and getting back the liveliness on our face is blush. So I found this color, this is going to be one of my favorite color from Innisfree. It is very peachy pink, if you guys see. It is definitely more of pink and less of pink, but it's a beautiful color, something really nice for Indian skin tone. And you will use blush on the apple of the cheeks. Okay, and your blush has to look really, really soft and gentle. It should not look like, you know, a line, a block of blush here, a block of blush here. No, it has to look even and blended. So what you will do is, you will use your blush around your apple of the cheeks. Okay? So how do you blend your cheeks? You will take your ring finger, okay? And just on the cheek bone is where you will use this highlighter. You can notice the way I'm using my highlighter. With really short strokes, and there's hardly any pressure on her skin. Do you feel any pressure? No, right? So it becomes patchy if you, you know, just go ahead and straight away dab it like this. No, that's wrong. Don't do that, okay? Take away the excess product on your palm. And the proper right amount of product will be there on your finger, ring finger, and just blend it away. Highlighter powder. So I'm taking a smaller brush and I'm taking the highlighter powder. And again, you will just dab it. Who loves using this color? Yeah? Why do we use this color? Yeah. And also give that nice intense look to your lashes. If you see, otherwise normally our lashes are really beautiful, but they are not very dark, right? So to give that nice open eye look, that nice intense look, at least we have to use mascara, which will give that enough volume and will help to achieve a very open eye. Down. Now for the lower outer corner lashes, I'm going to go directly outside her eyes. The same way as I had done the kajal, the tight lining thing. For the middle one, I'm going to go all straight upwards. And for the inner side, I will ask them to go outside first. Stretch it. And fill in those lashes inside. Throughout the day, and maybe for the night,